Hey guys, how's it going? Paul V here for UFGyms.com. I've got a special guest on the UF newsletter today. I want to introduce you guys to my good friend, Dr. Phil Knapp.
Hey guys.
this is going to be the start of a new affiliation between Ultimate Fitness Gyms and Arn Prayer Family Chiropractic. Phil is one of the good doctors over at Arn Prayer Family Chiropractic. Am I saying that right, Phil? Am I getting the right swag?
Arn Prayer Chiropractic Health Center.
Okay.
On the corner of Daniel and Charles. Little plug there.
What's the blog?
Arn Prayer, blog.arnprayerchiropractic.ca.
All right, that's a mouthful, but you can rewind it and check it out. So I just want to introduce you guys to Phil. And we're going to use this as an opportunity to tear down the wall of misconception that chiropractors and doctors don't actually lift weights and aren't athletes. Because Phil, you're an athlete, right?
Washed up meathead, yeah.
Washed up meathead. Maybe just tell us a little bit about your athletic background and where you got to where you're going.
As a kid, played hockey all the way through, and then spent a year in major junior, a year in tier two, and then played 5 years of Canadian university hockey before going to chiropractic. So spent a lot of time in the gym and beat up our bodies, or my body, on the ice as well.
Okay, so you probably, like, you can put the puck in the net and stuff, right?
Yeah, dump and chase.
Dump and chase.
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, cool. And the other thing that I want to show you guys, I'm just going to turn the camera here a little bit. Phil actually lifts weights, and that's him over there squatting today. And maybe what we'll do is we'll just, you know, again, we're tearing down the walls of misconception. Phil's an athlete. He lifts weights. He's a chiropractor. And we're going to get a shot of him hitting a set of squats here. Interrupting his workout.
So we're lifting light today.
This is deload day, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Excuse my terrible camera work. Full depth. A little parallel, drilling him with good head position too. And spotted only by the camera. Great set, Phil.
The only thing I felt there was some tightness in the right calf, right ankle.
Okay. So maybe that's a good lead off to us to talk about calves, and we're going to work from, you know, working from the bottom up to solve some issues.
Yeah.
All right, let's get on the floor and do a little calf smash, see if we can't clear you up.
Sounds good.
Okay, so we're here with Dr. Phil. He was squatting today. He's got a little bit of tightness in his calves, and we're going to spend a couple of minutes and put some passes in on the foam roller, smashing them up. So he's sitting sitting on the floor, going to go north-south just with a couple of passes to loosen everything off. Also sawing east to west across the grain. We can throw the other leg over top as well for some added support. And if you've got a super friend handy, and the super friend can reach in and apply some pressure as well. And we check out the face he's making there. All right, super friend, he's going into the pain cave on that one. All right. Probably want to spend at least, I would say if you're pre-workout, you're going to want to spend at least a minute to a minute and a half per side, giving it a quick aggressive throwdown. Post-workout, you could probably spend about 4 minutes per side.